Hi, I'm Lewis Jones with Mimaki USA. Today I'll be giving some tips and tricks on different methods of printing to acrylic boards. If you've been on social media lately, you've probably seen ads for acrylic signs with custom photos or music playlists, perfect for home decoration. Since these work as great personalized gifts, in the spirit of the holidays, I wanted to show off how we could make these using Mimaki UV inks. Because of the variety of printers in Mimaki's catalog, I could think of multiple ways to print to acrylic signs. So in this video, I'll be covering two of these methods. First, printing and applying clear material to acrylic signs using the UJV 100 and CG cutter. And second, using the UJF 6042 Mark IIe to print directly to the acrylic. Let's get printing.
All right, so the first method I'm going to use is printing on clear material. I'm going to be starting by setting up my art file. And with these methods, I'm going to be printing second surface, so all of my artwork needs to be mirrored. I'm doing that in Illustrator first. I'm going to make three copies on the same art file because I'm going to be printing on the UJV 100 and then bringing it over to the CG cutter, so I won't be duplicating this and rationing. It's actually easier just to make copies here in Illustrator and make sure everything prints together, my artwork, my crop marks, everything. I've already made my cut lines and now I'm making my crop marks in fine cut using fine cut tools. I'm going to use fill in the registration marks so that the CG cutter has an easier time reading them. The objects that fine cut created to surround the crop marks, I'm going to bring those over into a separate layer called white, and I'm going to make that my white layer. I'm going to add in some more background objects, make them magenta, and I'll turn all of that into a white plate in Rasterlink. All right, so here I have my artwork layer and I have my white layer, both I brought into Rasterlink. My white layer, I'm gonna use monocolor to select everything that's magenta and turn it into white. Now in the composition section, I'm going to composite my white layer to print on top, my artwork to print on bottom. Like I said, everything's second surface. This is the reason why we mirrored everything in Illustrator at the beginning. Once I have my artwork printed, I'm going to bring that roll over to the CG cutter, plug in my laptop or plug in my computer, and the exact same art file that I used to print. I'm going to open that up, open up fine cut, and I'm going to start plotting. Once in fine cut, I need to rotate my artwork so that it matches what it looks like on the CG cutter. You see, the sensors are going to have a much easier time reading those crop marks on that clear material because there are those white squares around it. That process works well with shiny material or neon material, anything that the sensor might find difficult to read. Thank you. Now moving on to the second method where I'm going to be printing directly to the acrylic. I still need to reverse everything. I still need to be aware of making a white layer and make sure that the white layer prints on top of the artwork. But I can do all that in RashiLink. I don't need to worry about reversing an Illustrator. I don't need to worry about making crop marks. I really just need to focus on making my white layer. So my background layer, that is just so it's easier for me to work with white objects. This new layer I'm making, I'm labeling white and I'm copy and pasting all of my artwork onto there and changing everything to magenta. Really just needs to be a CMYK color. That's the only prerequisite for making a white layer using monocolor. Now, if you see a white halo around your finished product, sometimes that means that your white layer is a tiny bit bigger than your artwork, maybe a couple of centimeters. You can choke back your white ink layer in RashiLink, but I'm doing it here in Illustrator just to save time. All right, so once I bring both of my layers into RashiLink, I'll show you a different way of making a white layer. With your white layer selected, go to Special Plate, select White, then Valid Pixel, and then Create, and it'll make its own special white layer that you can then composite. Just like in the other method, make sure my white is printing on top, but I'm also gonna make sure to click Reverse so that everything is mirrored. To make sure that my acrylic is lined up in the right place on the printer, I'm going to use the jig function. Aligning my artwork the way I think it's going to be, I'm going to make a new preset preference. And here I can type in the values of my artboard, values of the border that I want printed along with the artwork. I'm going to print all this on a blank sheet of paper. And then I will use that border to perfectly line up my acrylic to where I know the artwork will be. So once I lay down my acrylic sheet exactly where I need it, the only treatment that this material needs is some anti-static spray. Spray that on a microfiber cloth and wipe down the acrylic right before printing.